Can you ovulate more than once in a menstrual cycle? Do you have more than one opportunity to get pregnant between one period and the next? The answer to this question is no. And yes, kind of. Confused? In this video, I'm going to give you the facts around ovulation and if it's possible to ovulate more than once in a menstrual cycle. Hi, I'm Juliette Millar. I'm a trained natural fertility specialist with over 20 years experience. And welcome to Focus on Fertility, the YouTube channel dedicated to supporting you on your fertility journey with science-based tips and information you can trust to help you get pregnant as soon as possible. Okay, to start off, I'm going to apologize in advance for my accent when I say the word egg, spelt E-G-G, because I know that to a lot of you this will sound like egg, and I'm going to be saying it a lot in this video. But that's the way we say it down here in New Zealand. So before I answer the question on whether it's possible to ovulate more than once in a menstrual cycle, firstly, I want to clarify exactly what I mean by ovulation and what I mean by a menstrual cycle. Ovulation is the release of a mature egg from one of your ovaries. And of course, once that egg has been released, it's then available to be fertilized by sperm. So obviously, you can only get pregnant in a given month if you've released an egg, if you've ovulated. And a menstrual cycle is the time frame between the start of one period and the start of your next period. And a normal menstrual cycle can be anywhere between 21 and 35 days in length. So, can you ovulate or can you release an egg more than once in a menstrual cycle? The short answer is no, but this takes a bit of clarification. Ovulation can only occur at one point in your menstrual cycle. So, for example, you can't ovulate one day and then a few days later or a week later ovulate again. But it is possible for more than one egg to be released on the day that you ovulate. If two or more eggs are released, then this is known as multiple ovulation. But these multiple eggs will be released within 24 hours of each other, not days or weeks apart. And of course, this is how you get fraternal twins or non-identical twins. If two eggs are released at ovulation and they both get fertilized, then you can get pregnant with two babies at the same time, non-identical twins. Now, here's the really important bit. After ovulation, the empty follicle or sac that contained the egg in your ovary transforms into a gland called the corpus luteum. And this corpus luteum starts pumping out the hormone progesterone. And it's the presence of this progesterone that prevents your body from ovulating again in that particular cycle. You can only ovulate again once you get your next period and you start a new menstrual cycle. So where does this confusion around ovulating more than once come from? One of the most common sources is the use of ovulation predictor kits or OPKs, those little kits that are designed to help you figure out when you're ovulating. The important thing to know here is that OPKs don't actually detect ovulation itself. What they're detecting is a hormone called luteinizing hormone, or LH, which surges just before you ovulate. Normally, there's only one LH surge before you ovulate. But it is possible to have more than one LH surge or to have a very long LH surge. And these can both result in multiple positives on your OPK, which can give you the false impression that you're ovulating more than once. And this is one of the many reasons I don't recommend using OPKs alone to figure out when you're ovulating. And if you're interested in finding out more about the pros and cons of OPKs and why they can sometimes delay the time it takes to conceive, I'll link to my free fertility guide on this topic below. Another source of confusion around ovulating more than once probably comes from a scientific study back in 2003, which really shook up the scientific thinking around egg development and ovulation. The researchers discovered that rather than a single wave or single group of follicles developing and leading to ovulation during the menstrual cycle, two or three waves of follicle development seemed to occur. And this raised the question as to whether more than one ovulation was possible. But the important point here, and one that seemed to be ignored by the media reporting on this at the time, was that all the women in the study still ovulated only once in their menstrual cycle. And finally, if you're tracking your cervical fluid and you've noticed multiple episodes of fertile fluid instead of just the one episode that you'd expect to see before ovulation, then this might have also had you wondering if you can ovulate more than once in a cycle. But multiple patches of fertile cervical fluid are usually the result of your body making more than one attempt at ovulation before finally going ahead and releasing the egg. And again, only one ovulation will occur, though sometimes in this situation, you might not ovulate at all. So to summarize, it is not possible to ovulate more than once in a menstrual cycle, but you can release more than one egg during a single ovulation. And if you want to know the two easiest methods that I recommend for finding out if you're ovulating for sure, check out my video on this that I'll link to up here and in the description below. So that's it for today. If you found this video useful, please give it a big thumbs up, give it a like, and let me know in the comments if you found it helpful and what you found of most value. And of course, if you'd like to see more videos like this one, make sure to subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. I hope that helps. Thanks for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you in another video soon. Bye for now.